Good evening, teacher, and welcome to my presentation. As you know, the topic as well is semantic, but the topic is divided by the members of the group, and I belong to the topic or the specific topic of the specific rule, sorry, of the semantics of compositionality. To be more specific, I'm going to explain now when compositionality goes awry. Okay, let's start. First, let me try. Okay, listen here. First, we have to know that there exist three cases when compositionality could be broke down. It means that it's not just case in which the compositionality can be awry. Okay, we have anomaly, metaphor, and idioms. These three are defaults, to say something, of when compositionality broke down. Okay, I'm going to give you now a general idea or a general meaning of these three cases, because one of my partners is going to be more deeply in each of them, and also he will give you some other advices like the kind of metaphor, the kind of idioms, the kind of anomaly. Now I'm going to give you just a brief definition, just to get in what is this. Okay, first, anomaly. It can occur by two reasons. First, it can happen if the sentence is syntactically correct but semantically wrong. For example, colorless green ideas sleep furiously. In here, the sentence have a subject and a predicate, as we can see here, have a subject and a predicate, but at the same time, it doesn't have a meaning at all. And as we know, compositionality is based on the semantic rules of the meanings. It means that in this case, the sentence can be syntactically correct, but if the sentence at the time to use the rules of semantically or semantics, it doesn't deal with the rules of semantic, it cannot be combined as a compositionality, because we have to know that the rule of compositionality, or the main purpose of compositionality, is the meaning of the word and then the meaning of a phrase of a sentence. Okay, we are going to move to the other. Okay, the other reason of anomaly is when occur if the sentence is uninterpretable or simple, it doesn't make any sense at all. It presents a lack of meaning. What made that compositionality goes awry? Okay, in this other case, we see that if a sentence, you can read a sentence, but the sentence doesn't have a meaning, it is like lack of meaning. You can repeat it, the sentence, trying to get what the sentence what wants to share to you, but at the end, you didn't understand. That's because the sentence doesn't have meaning, and then it cannot be compositionality because it don't have meaning. And as I'm saying, the main purpose of compositionality is the meaning of the words. Here we have one example. running hills. When you read it, streets running hills, it doesn't make any sense. You can read it and it doesn't have any sense, and also it don't have a specific structure like in the first case, that we have a predicate and we have a subject But in this case, the sentence is just there. A sentence that is there without any kind of meaning. With the lack of meaning, they broke the compositionality rule. As I'm saying, the lack of meaning breaks down and get that compositionality gets over. This is the first anomaly, but my partner is going to be more deeply in this. We are going to move to the other one. Metaphors. These are some interesting because I think that metaphors are one of the, or is one of the most known of the people. And people do not use to know that this is the metaphors have a lack of meaning. What I mean of this is because metaphors deals with the direct comparison related to another unrelated thing. It means that one thing can be something, but if you are relating with other thing that doesn't have a direct comparison, you are changing the meaning. It means that doesn't have a specific meaning. For that reason, it gets in a broke of compositionality. When it that don't do not have a specific meaning at all, that made the lack of meaning and the rule cannot be applied, as I'm saying. Semantics always deal with meanings, and that's true, because semantics is related always with meanings, and that's the main reason of semantics and as well of compositionality. We have here a simple metaphor. As I'm saying, my partner is going to give you more examples of metaphor, but I just took the top of the iceberg to say something. The simplest form of a metaphor says one thing is another thing. As I'm saying, it gives another meaning that is not related with this, the meaning that the thing is. Example: he is a monster. Here we use in figurative language, so this does not mean the author is talking about an actual monster. It means the author is talking about a human who is behaving like a monster. It means that you are saying to one person that is a monster because his behavior or her behavior is crazy, to say something. And for that reason, you are comparing him and making that metaphor. Okay, we're going to move to other idioms, the third one and the last one. Okay, their idioms are something interesting because they help a lot, but in compositionality they broke down the rules. The idioms are well known as give figurate or literal meanings to a phrase or an expression, but as they do not have a specific meaning at all, it cannot be compositionality. As I said, if this don't have a specific meaning, it cannot be compositionality. If you use idioms, you have to be careful. This is not related with the topic, but we have to note that when we use idioms, we have to be very careful, because idioms can help us a lot to rise up the meaning of a phrase, of a word. But if we made a mistake, the people, or we use an unrelated idiom, the people can misunderstand what we are trying to say in the speech or in the sentence, and they can get mad. For that reason, idioms need to be in use in a very careful way. Here we have some. I really feel under the weather today. Yes, the whole 9 yards. Take it with a grain of salt. Fit as a fiddle. All of these are relating another things. For example, this: take it with a grain of salt. is telling us, like, taking with a grain of salt, like, you know how tiny is a grain of salt, and that made that we do that comparison. Okay, to give you a brief summary of the when compositionality goes agree is when the use of the rule of compositionality have a lack of meaning. It means that if a word or a phrase that we are trying to apply the semantic rule of compositionality do not have a specific meaning, or the meanings are related with other things, they cannot be compositionality, and they broke the rule of compositionality. Remember, we have anomaly, metaphor, and idioms. Okay, we are going to move to the other part, that are word meaning. Okay, in word meaning can depend of knowledge, imagination, and human understandable resource. Okay, what I'm trying to say with this, it means that if we want to get or understand the meaning of a specific word, we have to be careful, because I'm going to give you an example. If you work as a chef or a doctor, okay, and you use a specific words of the branch of medicine, if that you know the meaning of that words, but if you are telling that words of medicine to a person that works as a professor, perhaps he will not understand what you are saying, and he are not going to get the meaning of the word, because he do not study that. That is applied with the knowledge, because the word meaning is with the knowledge. As we know, when we know new words, we understand new things. Like, is where in case when we start to study English, we do not have meaning of a lot of words, and with the time we have get some knowledge, and the knowledge allow us to get the meaning of some words. And at the time of being 4 years studying, we have or we can understand some words that 4 years ago we didn't know the meaning. That's deal with knowledge. Now, with imagination, it deals with your imagination, as it says. Your mind is the best tool you can use for word meaning. It means that if you listen one word that you do not have any idea, just to listen the word, you can give a specific meaning to that word. You're asking, how come? Okay, if you're a baby and you if you are 5 years old and you listen a word like operation, okay, you can figure, because you are referring an operation like to in medicine, but you can imagine that operation like to operate a machine, to operate something. It means that you can give the meaning of a word with your imagination. And the last, human understandable resources. It means that the whole resources that you get as a human, since you are a child, you are getting resources of understandable in the school, in the other advisors, and nowadays with the internet, you can get a lot of knowledge about words. This is something very hard, because it happens with the poets and also even with professors, because they are talking in a way, but if you don't know what they, in which meaning they are saying the words, you cannot understand that. Okay, to summarize it, the word meaning is related with knowledge, imagination, and human understandable resource. You have to be carefully and use your mind when you are trying to know or give a meaning. Okay, teacher, this is all of my part. I guess everything is clear, and that's all. And sorry if you have heard some noises around my house, but the thing is that there is raining a lot, and if I didn't do it by now, I cannot be uploaded for tomorrow on YouTube. Thank you so much, and have a good night, teacher.